Hi, Dick.
Hello.
Finally back again in Italy. It's always a pleasure to have you here.
Grazie.
Last time, it was 1 year ago, that you were here in Italy. We were coming out from the first wave of the coronavirus. We are still in the coronavirus period, but however, life it's a bit more normal this time. Isn't it right?
Yes, yeah. Numbers are a little bit going up in Holland, but the tournaments will take place. So there will be a busy time for all of us, for all the top players. So we are ready for this.
For the new challenges.
Yes.
And this is an important visit because of many things to talk after 1 year, even if we recently met in Andernos in France. Because this year has a special meaning, is a 30 year of collaboration between the Longoni family, I would say family, not the brand, because it's a relation between people, and Dick Jasper. And I can consider that is one of the longest continuous relation in our team. And this makes us very proud to have you with us.
Thank you.
How does it started?
In October 1990, Mr. and Mrs. Longoni, your parents, approached me in a tournament in Antwerp, and I was coming up as a talent in the Netherlands, and I heard rumors that your parents were approaching me for making a new queue for me. So I was thrilled to hear this news. That Italian queue factory wants to make a new queue. It was the deep gray model. It came out in 91. And in beginning of 91, February, I signed my first contract with the Longoni company. And
in Italy or in the Netherlands you signed?
No, in Italy. I came to Italy, to Mariano Comenza for the first time. And yes, I signed.
Did you came alone or with some partner we had in the Netherlands?
No, I came with Ludo Dilis. At that time, he was also being sponsored by Longoni and with Dirk Verhoeven. He's one of the Longoni dealers in Belgium. So with three of us, we went to, we had this beautiful road to Italy through Switzerland. I still remember.
A long trip. Yes. With the car like it used to be at that time.
Yes.
Today is a bit different. In this 30 year, we made together many models, but you achieved an enormous number of titles. And how many world titles? These are the most important. How many world titles did you get?
I won four world championships. First one was in 2000 in France, Saint-Étienne. The second was in the Netherlands in 2004 in Rotterdam. The third was 2011 in Lima, Peru. And the fourth was not so long ago in Cairo, Egypt, 2018. Which I won the world title in a very thrilling match in penalties from Jeremy Bury from France. Very exciting final. And yeah, a world title is your highlight of your career. And
you were winning these four world titles, but you had also a lot of World Cup titles that are also very important and prestigious. By the way, in Cairo, I was there with you. In Saint-Étienne, I was there. It was one of my first trip for the company. Yeah. I just entered the company in that time. And I have always very good memory of a visiting tournament where you were playing. In this 30 year, you got a lot of title from our side. We developed together with you a lot of models. Many people still remember the first model that it was the name. It was
a deep gray.
Deep gray. So
yes.
That was the first one with your name on it.
Yes, and the funny thing is that before the first queue has been made for me, the deep gray model. I also played with the Longoni Q, the Ludo Dilis Q I bought in 85, so 5 years before my first model. So you can say that I played the three cushion game all my life with one brand, the Longoni brand, and which brought me a lot of success and fame we continue.
Good. And so you had the deep gray, then it was the professional 99.
Yes, then the new age.
The new age.
And then the DJ 08. And then the blades. That was
the blades.
A very special design of the ballpoint model. And after that, the Hollanda series.
Which was, when it was the moment that you switched from boot joint to DP2 joint? It was with the Hollanda or with the...
Blades.
With the blade.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
And then you find yourself comfortable...
Yes, immediately. I saw it as a big step, a big improvement. Wood is more sensitive, putting the Q inside. Putting the shaft inside, and the VP2 was very easy to adapt and to handle. And yes,
today is a standard. That when we started with Carom, boot joint was the only joint, except when we were producing Kai Shimada model, that we experimented some double joint like system, and then we switched to VP2. And Four Caramel is made in titanium. I take the occasion to announce, as we are talking about model, about an Hollanda Q that we are going to launch this year. And it will be a limited edition to celebrate the 30th year anniversary. And it's based on the famous style of Hollanda Q, but it contains some new feature that we can see here. For example, the most innovative part are the two stainless steel ring that we have on the bottom side and the central part of the Q that are shaped with a curvy profile, and they close the butt at the two edges. This Q is made with in the frontal part what we call forearm in Ural, and the back part is a wood called Renga, very similar to Cocobolo, but not Cocobolo. And we have a core system in graphite, so the internal part is an hexa core but made with graphite to adapt balance and power in the heat. So today we will provide you two butts of the new Hollanda to test. Actually, which type of shaft are you using?
Last year I played with the S20 and the S30 shaft, and last half year I'm playing most of the time with the S30 shaft.
Which profile? The profile of the shaft is the E69.
Oh yeah, the E69. Yeah. Always in all those years, I didn't change because I feel comfortable with.
You never tried the longer one, the 71.
Maybe in the beginning of my career, but for many years, I don't like to change.
Okay,
it's working for me, and. I avoid to stop thinking in my head about what could be better, what could be better for me. So I leave it like it is. For me, 69, the E69 and the S30 shaft is at the time now my favorite shaft.
Okay. And now, since 2 years, we started promoting a lot our graphite shaft that is called Luna Nera. The philosophy of the company is leave the player free to use the shaft where they are more comfortable with. But today you had the chance to test it in our room. And which are your feeling on the shaft?
I don't feel that much difference between the Luna Nera and the S30. But if I want to decide to play with the Luna Nera, I have to test it some time.
Players are always sensitive to changes. Today we will provide you the cues, and then you will make all the tests, all the necessary tests, and then you do the right choice for your game. That's the most important philosophy of Longoria.
I will sure test some shots with the Luna Nera shaft. I'm sure that I will do that one day. For the time being, we have big tournaments on the way now, so I stick to my S30 or S20 shaft. And
that's the right. That's right. And one thing that always is coming with you, together with you, Q, is the Longoni Giotto bag. How do you find yourself with the Giotto bag?
Yeah, it's a very solid, good protection. It's a real leather, and we have good small bags on the Q bag to put all stuff in. It's very practical to take along. It fits in my suitcase. Two butts, six shafts.
It can go up to four butt eight shaft, but two by six is already good.
So it's a perfect size.
Not many people know, but these two bags are totally made in Italy, and we decide to introduce this high end cue bag because it's the perfect match with our cues. Somebody that is looking for an exclusive product needs also an exclusive bag to protect, to keep the cue protected from mechanical shock, but from weather, from humidity, and everything. Which are your next tournament in the coming weeks?
Next week, beginning of November, we have the World Cup in Veghel, in the Netherlands. That's the first World Cup tournament.
Since how many months?
Since February 2020 in Antalya. That was the last one, just before Corona crisis started. After Veghel, I have an invitation tournament, Lausanne, Billiard Masters in Switzerland. That's a week after. 2 weeks after, we have the World Cup in Sharm el-Sheikh, Egypt. And directly combined with that World Cup, we have the World Championship in Sharm el-Sheikh. So four big events in the coming 6 weeks.
So one after the other. And in January, you have already some news about possible event, if the situation stay like it is?
Yeah, probably we should go to South Korea again for the big 5 and 6 event. We will see William Orr next week in Veghel, so he will give us updates about this tournament. 2 weeks, a two-week event. And we have the National Masters in the Netherlands, beginning of January. In February, we have the World Cup in Turkey, Antalya maybe Ankara, I don't know, somewhere in Turkey. So,
but I think we cannot go any further because we have to see the development of the situation and let's hope that it will be easy coming on.
Yes, I have some confidence that the tournaments will take place, and maybe restrictions will be a little stronger, a little higher. But I think we can play. And I think it's really important that we can play, because we should carry on. We should continue with the tournaments now.
So what else I can say? I can just say thanks, Dick. Yes. For all your coming tournament, this is your companion.
Yes, this is my weapon. And I also want to say thank you very much, Longoni Company, for the so many years of collaboration and trust in me. And I'm very happy. I'm very happy with this beautiful new model. And thank you for the 30th anniversary Q. It's for me also a special moment. I can say I'm very happy to continue like this. And I try to bring on good results. And I will do everything for that. Thank you.
Thanks for being part of the Longoni family. And we wanted to have you always with us. Thanks, Dick.
Thank you. Grazie.
Bye.
Grazie.